Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Mr. V. Welcome to another edition of Virtual Learning with Mr. Viveiros. Today is April 29th, 2020. It is Wednesday. Got some final touches. We're going to be wrapping up Word Generation 2.06 today. Does Title IX promote gender fairness in sports and education? We'll be taking a look at the debate the issue section. But before we get there and get to our agenda, gonna kick us off with a little bit of music. Beautiful weather outside today. I'm really enjoying the sunshine, the, you know, little wisps of clouds that are actually flying around up there. Pretty nice day, and got some exciting news to share with you all. But before we get there, let's start it off with some music. Here we go. Get back to that hit song from the band Foster the People. The song is called Coming of Age. Great song when I think about today's weather. It feels like we're coming of age here as far as, you know, everything seems to be blooming outside. The grass is looking a little extra green. You got some dandelions growing out there. Also, it looked like, I don't know if they're wildflowers or what, but I've got these weird little pink, not pink, but purple flowers growing in the field outside. I didn't plant them, but they're just there. I'm not exactly sure if they're wildflowers or lilacs or I don't necessarily know. Okay, horticulture is not my expertise. But before we continue on, let's get to our agenda of the day. I'm going to take you on over here. Try this without standing up today. It seems like every time I stand up, I really mess this up. But no, I do have to stand up because my arms are too short. All right. So starting off today with our question of the week, how do you like your toast? Going to talk a little bit about that, as well as some news regarding phase one and phase two assignments. Again, they should be completed by next Tuesday, which is May 5th, 2020. We also, just a reminder, we have our Doran softball enrichment today at 3:30 p.m. with Haley King from the Boston Red Sox. Anybody interested in attending that, you know, just shoot me an email. You could definitely join. Really interesting story that Haley has to share with us about how she got involved with the Red Sox. Then we're going to get to our work period. Like I mentioned before, day four, Word Generation 2.06. Does Title IX promote gender fairness in sports and education? We'll review the debate the issue section, which is page 35. We'll take a look at the notes that I've prepared for you as well as the evidence. And then we'll take a look at some of the response expectations and the rubric. To wrap things up, just going to quickly preview tomorrow's lesson, Word Generation 2.07, which is a new unit. Should the government fund embryonic stem cell research? Our lesson vocabulary for today's lesson are the words inequity, adequate, disproportionate, resources, and illustrate. All right, bring it back on over here to ground zero. All right, so to talk briefly about this week's question of the week, how do you like your toast? All right, it looks like we are at a dead tie. okay? 7 Harvard and 7 Yale are each tied with 5 engagements this week. So 5 students in each class have answered this question. Again, 7 Yale, don't be sitting on your hands out there. 7 Harvard is coming strong for that championship of being, of dethroning you, I should say, of your championship. And, you know, becoming the question of the week champions. All right, 7 Yale, let's see if we can get those responses up to what we saw last week and the week before that earned you that championship. 7 Harvard, keep coming. All right, keep 7 Yale honest. I think you guys can definitely surpass them this week and claim that question of the week championship. A couple of other things that I had mentioned in my agenda today, talk just real quick about assignment expectations. Again, you need to make sure that you have your assignments completed by next Tuesday, which is May 5th, 2020. We'll be through our phase one and phase two work by that point. And again, I haven't received any additional information about how that work will be submitted, but just wanted to make sure that we're all on pace to have these assignments done by that time. Last but not least, actually I have one more piece of evidence I didn't include on there. It's not evidence. I'm so like routed and thinking about today's lesson and evidence and evidence and evidence that I said evidence, but I have another little tidbit of news, I should say. But first, today's Doran softball team enrichment activity again at 3:30 p.m. will be live on Google Meet. If you guys would like to tune in or join and ask some questions, again, this is an opportunity for you. This isn't about the adults talking with Haley King, who is a ball girl for the Boston Red Sox, or at least she was while she was in college. We can learn a little bit about her experience. And, you know, I think there's a lot of good questions we could ask her as far as, you know, one of the things I learned is that she was actually in charge of the ceremonial. There goes my cat. She was in charge of the ceremonial first pitch, which I thought was like, wow, like that's pretty cool because you get to meet a lot of famous people. So one of the questions I know I want to ask is, you know, which celebrity had her starstruck, you know? And lastly, this tidbit of information, this tidbit of news did not make it to the board because I literally just got it. But Miss Pettinati, right, shared a post on Google Classroom in regards to this. But Miss Pettinati has assembled some, you know, kind of word generation poster project assignments that you guys could complete at your own leisure. These are optional assignments, but I strongly encourage that you guys partake in them. I'd be really interested to see and, you know, kind of what you come up with and how you might express your opinion about some of these word generation topics through art. So, again, if you're interested in that and want to check it out, there is a link to the material on Google Classroom. The poster project that she seemed to focus on this week was actually last week's unit that we already completed in regards to, you know, should students be paid for their performance in school. So it'd be really interesting to see how you guys might visually present your argument. All right, without further ado, I know those of you out there are probably just like, all right, Mr. V, enough with your news and your, you know, opening 10 minutes of what you think is fun, but it's not fun for us. Let's jump right to today's work, shall we? Present my entire screen. And there we go. Okay, so my screen is being shared. There's my big fat head. All right, let's get to word generation 2.06. Debate the issue, which is page 35. Right here. Okay. So again, for our word generation essential questions, we're always writing a response to the essential question and preparing that response during day 4. You know, the next steps would be for you to complete your written response for word generation 2.06 after this lesson, using perhaps some of the evidence that, you know, I present and gather for you, as well as some any additional evidence or examples that you can come up with on your own. So to begin, it asks us to, again, debate the issue, pick one of these positions or create your own. So we have an A position, a B position, and a create your own. One of the positions, the A position, says it is appropriate for colleges and schools to focus their resources on programs that generate more money, which you may have heard Mr. V mention earlier this week, and I'm kind of surprised to see that this was actually one of the opinions you could argue, or one of the claims you could argue in your response. Option B says athletic programs for males and females should receive equal funding. So again, Title IX should exist kind of as it is, and it should always just be equal money. And then lastly, we have the create your own option, which I did create one for you guys, but it's not necessarily the opinion that I share, and I'll get to that in a moment. And again, if you're doing this on this sheet over here in this column here, this is where you would jot down your evidence or examples that support your opinion over here. But if you're using the Google Doc, I'll take you over to that now and show you what that looks like. It's going to take a second here to load. Looks like the recording's going very well today. No issues. I haven't had any issues this week with recording stuff. I should knock on wood because I just jinxed myself. I guarantee you now that I said that, of course, I pulled the blanket down here. Of course, I'll probably start running into issues today or tomorrow. Hopefully not, though. All right. Hopefully I'm not jinxing myself. All right. So I'm going to scroll down now to the debate the issue notes for day four of We're Generation 2.06. Okay, come on. Almost there. Aha, here we go. I believe. Okay. Nope, day three. I got to keep going. That's why I teach English, guys. Mr. V can't even count. My math is off. Just kidding. All right, so day four is broken up as follows, okay? So day four, debate the issue. Just going to zoom in a little bit, make this a little bit bigger for everybody to see. There we go. So again, we have two different options that the text provides us to, you know, for our claim. So we have option A. All right, so step one is to pick one of these positions or one of these claims. So option A, or claim A, is appropriate for colleges and schools to focus their resources on programs that generate more money. So if you believe in option A, your feeling is that, you know, Title IX really shouldn't exist, and that it's the schools who should decide how resources are spent on programs, okay? And that, you know, a lot of times it seems that these schools would tend to focus their resources, just realized I bolted the wrong word, sorry, but they often tend to focus their resources on the programs that make the most money. And maybe you feel that that's okay, maybe that's the opinion that you have, but I do not necessarily support that opinion. I support option B, all right? As you can see, I've labeled this Mr. Viveiros' position because this is where I stand. And where I stand is that athletic programs to males and females should receive equal funding. So, in other words, Title IX should continue to exist because I feel like there's a lot of benefits as a result of Title IX existing. Now, the last position, again, I had a tough time coming up with this because this isn't necessarily my own position. So I kind of had to put myself in somebody else's shoes and say, all right, well, what if, you know, what if I didn't have option A or option B? Maybe I stand somewhere else, maybe somewhere along the middle. So the create your own position I wrote says, more needs to be done to ensure that Title IX eradicates gender inequity in sports and education. So for this, it's pretty much saying that, you know, it's not option B because it says that there needs to be more. Okay, more needs to be done. You know, it's not just a financial thing. More needs to be done, maybe to break that kind of, you know, for instance, we talked a lot yesterday about gender association with sports. And I had mentioned, like, you know, maybe elevating some of these female professional sports leagues on television. Maybe that's something that you feel needs to be done to truly eradicate the gender inequity in sports and education. All right. So I'm going to guide you through the evidence, okay? And the evidence, you'll see, again, everything lines up. So step two says gather evidence for your position. And for option A, I provided one piece of evidence. Option B, which was my opinion, I provided two pieces of evidence, which I've been doing every week. And the create your own position, I only provided one piece of evidence. So I'm going to break down the evidence and kind of tie it into the claim a bit for you, again, to further guide you through writing your response. So if you chose option A, it is appropriate for colleges and schools to focus their resources on programs that generate more money. You might use an example or evidence like this. So you might recall, I think this was from, from day two, do the math. I had written this in my response. I had said, for example, if a women's basketball team earns the college $10 million each year, but the men's gymnastics team only projects to earn $1 million for the college each year, then the women's program should not be taken away. So again, if you feel that the programs that earn the most money should be getting the most resources in colleges, then maybe that's evidence there that you might use to support your argument. Because again, a college getting $10 million is a lot different than a college getting $1 million. You can do a lot more with $10 million. It's 10 times a million, right? So maybe you feel that way. Maybe perhaps you feel that, you know, the programs that bring in the most money to the college or university, those programs should be the ones that take precedence or, you know, get the most resources. Now, my position, again, which is option B, athletic programs for males and females should receive equal funding. Perhaps you use evidence that sounds like this. In 1971, the year before Ham was born, fewer than 300,000 high school girls participated in school sports. That number has grown to over 3 million. Now, this evidence comes right from this week's issue. And clearly, I believe that this evidence, you know, illustrates the advantages of providing equal funding to athletic programs for males and females, because, you know, this clearly shows that since Title IX passed and since we mandated this law providing equal funding, this clearly shows that there's been a huge increase in women's or girls' participation in high school sports. An additional piece of evidence that I think illustrates this point or proves this point could be that, for example, the year Ham was born, only 9% of medical degrees were earned by women. That percentage has jumped to nearly 50%. So this was also taken from this week's issue. And again, I think this evidence helps to illustrate the importance of having equal funding for males and females, because, you know, before this time of Title IX, only 9% of medical degrees were earned by women, which, you know, clearly isn't a lot. That means 91% of all medical degrees went to men. Now we're seeing this, you know, kind of level out, right, where the percentage has nearly jumped to 50%. So we got, you know, roughly 50% women earning medical degrees each year and 50% men earning medical degrees each year. And I think all of that is a direct result of schools and athletic programs providing equal funding to both males and females. Now, the create your own position, again, I had to really, really dive for this evidence, but hopefully it makes some sense. But for the create your own, it says more needs to be done to ensure that Title IX eradicates gender inequity in sports and education. So evidence that you might choose to support this position, you know, maybe you take it back to Ms. Khan's data chart, which came, I forget exactly the source. It says it over here, the National Coalition for Women and Girls in Education. So this is, you know, a national organization where Ms. Khan got her data from. So again, maybe you feel that more needs to be done, and we could use this chart and maybe use a quote or example like this. According to Ms. Khan's data, a little more than 3 million girls participated in high school sports compared with close to 5 million boys. So again, this does show that there's still inequity in sports and education despite Title IX existing. So maybe you feel more needs to be done to close this gap. Clearly, you know, there are roughly about 2 million more boys who are interested in sports in high school when compared with women. And again, this data came, that evidence came right from this chart here, which we reviewed yesterday when we thought scientifically. Now, ultimately, again, I feel most of you who feel, you know, that Title IX has been beneficial are probably going to end up going with option B, right? Which is, sorry, I didn't mean to highlight the whole thing, but that is this claim here. Athletic programs to males and females should receive at equal funding. So if you agree that Title IX is a good thing and that it's been successful and that it has promoted gender fairness in sports and education like I do, then you may use this claim and you may also use this evidence. And then obviously make sure you explain this evidence. All right. Obviously, I did a little bit of that for you through this video. And if you need to go back, rewind, rewatch, you know, obviously you guys can do that. All right. You have that ability just by going to that little red scroll bar at the bottom of your YouTube and sliding it back. Okay. So again, I know that these day four lessons seem very brief, but one thing I need to always make sure is that we understand the next steps. So the next steps are for you guys to complete page 36, take a stand. Now, page 36 is this page here, take a stand, and it says support your position with clear reasons and specific examples. Try to use relevant words from the word generation list in your response. So you want to try to use, you know, as much of this vocabulary in your response as possible. And again, these expectations are outlined for you here. So it says next steps. Complete page 36. Again, the question, does Title IX promote gender fairness in sports and education? And it reads, students should use evidence from the reading and or my notes to support their responses. So you can use evidence directly from the reading packet, or you may even use evidence from my notes or some of the answers, the sample answers I provided. Students should review the response to text grading rubric. That is down here. We'll go over that real quick before we wrap up. Minimum one paragraph response, 5 to 7 original sentences. Guys, I need to stress this. 5 to 7 original sentences does not include evidence. Okay, so your evidence is not included in that 5 to 7 original sentence total. Again, thinking about the overall structure of our response, all right, using that response to text style, topic sentence, introduce evidence, okay, state your evidence, explain your evidence in like 2 to 3 sentences, state a second piece of evidence. All right. If you continue through that cycle, you know, and get in that habit of, again, topic sentence, introduce evidence, state evidence, explain evidence, you know, concluding or summation statement, you'll easily meet that 5 to 7 original sentence expectation. And if you have any questions about this, as always, maybe you want me to proofread your response or want me to take a look at it, feel free to, you know, shoot me an email, drop it in the comments, you know, let me know. I'd be more than happy to take a look at your response before you turn this in next week. Lastly, it's expected that you accurately use as many of the vocabulary terms from the lesson as possible. So the lesson vocabulary, again, are inequity, resources, adequate, disproportionate, and illustrate. Okay, those are our vocabulary terms. I would expect that, you know, maybe you use at least 3 of these words accurately in your response in order to meet that expectation. Lastly, here is the response to text grading rubric. We focused a lot in the past on exceeding the standard and meeting the standard. This is where you want to fall with your response. So again, I'm going to just review the exceeding the standard criteria because this is what we're aiming to do. So it says central idea is clear and fully developed. So again, your central idea is your opinion based on whether or not Title IX has been successful in promoting gender fairness in sports and education. All right. Is that idea present? Is it clearly present? Is it fully developed? Meaning, does it have evidence? Is it supported with explanation? Effective selection and explanation of evidence or details. Again, you have to make sure that you're choosing the right evidence to support your opinion. I provided you with some evidence through the document. Hopefully, you know, you're referencing that evidence and any other additional evidence that you feel might be needed or might be helpful in proving your response. And of course, it's always important that we explain our evidence. All right, don't just throw evidence out there and expect your audience to understand. You got to give the evidence and then explain how that evidence proves your claim. Effective organization, again, thinking of that response to text structure, topic sentence, introduce evidence, state your evidence, explain your evidence, some sort of concluding statement to wrap it all up. Clear expression of ideas. Again, your ideas are clearly understood, and that's, you know, again, mostly to do with you using proper English conventions and grammar and punctuation, so on and so forth. Full awareness of the purpose for writing. So again, you fully understand that this is an argumentative style of response, and you're aware that, hey, I have to present my opinion and I need to support my opinion with facts and evidence or examples from the reading. Lastly, demonstrates full understanding of most of the lesson vocabulary. And again, in order to satisfy this criteria, I would expect that you'd be able to use at least 3 of the 5 vocabulary terms accurately in your response. Okay, going to zoom out there. It seems like I'm getting really a lot better at time. Okay, I'm trying to time these videos and keep them within, you know, like that 25, 35, 40 minute range there, as opposed to doing like a full hour, because I don't want to lose your attention. And again, these are supplemental to some of the work that I'm doing during the day. And again, if you have any questions, jump in on a live session, 11 a.m. Monday through Friday. It's all linked on our Google Calendar, which is posted on my website. You can also all receive the email invite to my daily meetings. I would love to hear from you all. Last but not least, tomorrow we're going to get into Word Generation 2.07, which is a new unit, which is asking us whether or not the government should provide funding for embryonic stem cell research. Now, stem cells are something to do with your DNA. I actually got to do a little bit more background investigation around this topic so I can really speak intelligently about the topic, as opposed to, not sounding informed. So with embryonic stem cell research, that's a big controversy, because a lot of people, as far as what I know, just on the surface level, a lot of people are against this due to religious reasons and feeling like people should not be, messing with stem cells and modifying stem cells and embryos, because they consider, you're kind of like acting like God, making people, making things happen. So I'm going to do a little bit more research and reading about that tonight. But before I actually have that opportunity, I want to remind you all that today at 3:30 p.m., this is a Doran softball enrichment activity, but it's open to anybody who would like to participate. We'll be having a Google Meet with Haley King from the Boston Red Sox. And I would love for you all to be able to join us today if you can. I know it's a little bit later in the day and would be considered like after school hours. But again, we put this together for you guys. We want as much involvement in this video and in this meeting as possible. Okay, I guess that's just about it today. I'm going to turn it back over to some Foster the People. Again, the song of the day today is Coming of Age. And I just think that this song just like makes my blood boil. I know you're probably like, wow, Mr. B, like this song like gets you pumped up. And it does. Maybe you just need to watch the music video. Coming of age is the act of growing up. And this was a big theme we were going to be getting to with our reading of S.E. Hinton's The Outsiders. But unfortunately, since we are not going to be returning to school this year, we're not going to be able to get to The Outsiders, which I'm kind of bummed about, because that's personally one of my favorite books. But if I can encourage anybody to read it, if you would like a copy, I do have access to a PDF copy I could, send to you, and you could even use that for your independent reading. I just think it's a great story that young people should read and, check out. It's got a lot of important life lessons, I think. But anywho, I've digressed. Back to our closing segment of the day. Going to get to our song. Before I get to the song, make sure to wash them hands. I will see you all tomorrow for Word Generation 2.07. Have a good one, guys. Lyrics are like poetry. Just like an animal, I protect my pride when I'm too bruised to fight. And even when I'm wrong, I tend to think I'm right. But I'm bored of the game. I'm too tired to rage. It's my favorite part. I love the breakdown, the piano, and then the drums kick in. Ready? Here comes a sick drum solo. Ready? I miss you guys. Can't wait to see you all tomorrow. Have a great night. Take it easy, guys.